very simple answer to one question. Do you hate all white people?
I don't think it's a fair question. The white man doesn't even come into my attitude. Mr. Muhammad teaches us to love our own kind and let the white man take care of himself. For a white man today, sir, after kidnapping millions of black people from Africa, stripping them of all human characteristics and relegating them to the role of chattel or cattle or animals, commodity, merchandise that could be bought and sold at will, and then 100 years since the Emancipation Proclamation, using every type of deceptive method to further us into slavery, called second-class citizenship, I think that it would take a whole lot of nerve for white people today to ask Negroes, do they hate them?
And just to add value to this is that all the prejudices that Negroes have towards white people have been earned by white people as a collective, especially the white people who normally be the white people that are all the white people, because y'all don't be correcting each other. You come and correct Negroes on why we shouldn't be weary of you, wherein all the prejudices that white folks have against Negroes are media driven, and that means historically as well as in the present time. For example, when they say black on black crime, but while never mentioning white on white crime, black on black crime has absolutely nothing to do with the interaction between white and black people, whereas in black people don't go out of their way to attack white people or outsiders at all. When you start talking about hate crimes and the influx against the AABI, the overwhelmingly majority of those were done by white people, the same way when attacks on black people. There was 14 attacks on Asian folks in Los Angeles, and in that same year there was over 150 against black people. Guess who was the majority of all those attacks? White people, right? So all the tropes that they have against Negroes have absolutely nothing to do with interacting with them, but are prejudiced and racist, because it's how systemic racism works. However, comma, the things that white people do, like these Karens flipping out, calling us the N-word and da-da-da-da-da, that's an everyday thing. The microaggressions working in predominantly white workspaces, we swear to God, if five other white people, it's the most worst energy being the only black person in an all-white space, whereas white people, y'all can move freely in our spaces. Our cousin, our favorite cousin in the world, had pointed something out. She went on this cruise, and there was a party in somebody's cabin. Now, it wasn't a black party. It just so happened that all the people that were invited were Negroes, wherein this white couple passed by and saw it was jumping and walked in. One of the other people on the cruise had pointed out that if it happened in the inverse, they would have been like escorting the Negroes, like,
who invited you? Why are you here? Blah, blah, blah.
And in full-fledged confession, we used to crash skinheads. They put them in the paper, for crying out loud. But we'd be right up at the Galibán like we belong. And as long as we went there with somebody who was Mexican-ish in look, nobody ever questioned us. However, comma, if it was just a whole bunch of Negroes that walked in, guess what? But when y'all come to our spaces, you're safe. Everybody's safe in our spaces because Negroes, the African in us, is inviting. We embrace outsiders all the time. It's our way. And then plus that, white people coming to the hood for sex or drugs or just to a dance club or whatever, having harm done to them, that would be front page news. Same thing with any other outsiders. However, common when it's progress and unity and us building, especially black and brown unity, that doesn't make the news cycle all the time. Rarely. And when it does, it stays on like it was something about a puppy dog or a cat or something. Weird.
R-E-X.